Welcome. You've got the Nixon Report. So grab a pen and dial a friend. We're going to have a great show for you tonight. My guest is the Honorable Alderman Tony Foulkes. How are you doing, Alderman Foulkes?
Wonderful, thank you.
Alderman Foulkes is one of the most progressive aldermen in the city council in Chicago. Has tremendous energy and has accomplished many, many things in her career. And now it's my understanding that you're running for alderman in the 16th Ward.
Correct. Yeah, very correct.
Well, tell me something about yourself. Tell our audience something about you, Alderman Tony Foulkes.
All right. Well, I am just Tony on the block. I've lived in Inglewood. This year will be 45 years. And I tell everyone that it's personal to me. When I was a little girl, 7 years old, Inglewood was the place to live. It was, you know, booming with economic development, businesses, and I literally watched it spiral until, you know, the way it was when I was elected in 2007. And I wanted to change that because it was my home. It was where my friends and my family lived. And the only way to change it was to run for office, and that's what I did. And I won.
Absolutely. And, you know, I was spent a lot of time over about 7 or 8 years. I was in St. Louis. I was one of the coordinators for President Obama's campaign there. And while I was there, something strange happened to the ward that I lived in, the 15th Ward. I came back and it seemed like the city council had done some gerrymandering and they took a chunk of the ward that I lived in and that you represent, the 15th Ward, and they changed it, and we found a substantial amount of that ward in the 16th Ward. So why are you running for alderman in the 16th Ward, Alderman Foulkes?
Well, you're exactly right. In the remap, the 15th Ward was gerrymandered and it became a Latino ward. So it's like 77% Latino. And 40% of the ward that I currently represent right now is now in the 16th Ward. So I'm running to keep representing the people that I have been representing. And we're close enough to the 23% that will still have contact. So that's the biggest thing that the constituents are saying. We're losing you. I'm like, no, ward beyond boundaries. You're not losing me. The only thing I can't do is infrastructure and sign the papers, but my goal is that we all work together.
What's your punch number?
My punch number is 53. It's the exact number I had in 2007.
Punch 53.
Vote for me,
you
punch
know,
53.
5 and 3 is 8, and 8 means a new beginning. That's very interesting.
Wow.
You have some impressive endorsements. You've been endorsed by the Honorable President of a Cook County Board, President Tony Prickwinkle, someone that I know from Hyde Park, someone who is a very formidable elected official. Very brilliant, very smart, and a winner.
And we have the same name and the same birthday.
Oh, my goodness.
Well, we were TNT when we were in council.
All right, now. Okay, you've got AFSCME Union. You've got the Action Now. You've got the Chicago Firefighters Union. The Chicago Teachers Union. The Citizens Action of Illinois. The Coalition of Black Trade Unionists, the Cook County College Teachers Union, the SEIU Union, the Grassroots Illinois Action, the UFCLO Local 881, the United Working Families, and the Citizens to Abolish Red Light Cameras. Now I'm going to stop on that note because you... we could just go on and on.
Wait a minute, I got to correct you on one thing, though.
Yes.
It's UFCW. That's my local. That's UFCW.
So that's I stand corrected. Local 881. I want to make sure we get that correct.
That's my people.
But back to the Citizens to Abolish Red Light Cameras. Now, you have a real distinction in terms of this whole mass movement. I was doing some research and I found out that 75% of the people in Chicago, when polled, don't like red light cameras. And what was your distinction as a alderman?
Well, at first I voted for it. And I thought that if people didn't run red lights, then they would get a ticket. But what we found out later, that it wasn't what it was supposed to do.
Mm-hmm.
And there was some little trickery there. So I had spoke to the gentleman with the Citizens to Abolish Red Light Cameras.
Yes.
And I decided that I would sign on to, I was the first alderman, I believe,
you were
for a long time.
The very first alderman to sign the petition against red light cameras in the city of Chicago.
Yeah.
That's an amazing thing, because there seems to be a groundswell of support against that institution as it is now established. And looking into it, you're finding out all kinds of corruption took place, all kinds of deals.
Mm-hmm.
That is really an amazing thing. Now, some of the things that you're interested in that I'd like you to speak to are your issues on public safety, education, which includes technology, jobs, and economic development. Let's start with public safety.
Well, back in 2007, when I ran the first time, we found out that that was the most important thing that people cared about, was public safety. And I also think that is the number one. I think it's the foundation of any community. You know, in West Englewood in Chicagoland, we had two of the highest crime rates in 7th and 8th District. And with my work that I've done, working with the police department, the superintendent, being active in schools, you know, a whole wraparound type of thing that I did with the residents, we're no longer, not even on the top three. So both of the current ward districts.
Yes.
And I believe if people don't feel safe, no economic development is coming.
Absolutely.
You know, you can put whatever you want, you know, if people, and I, you know, the newest thing, we talk about the Whole Food. And if people don't feel safe, and they're on the Dan Ryan, and they're coming from Chatham or something.
That's right.
And if they don't feel safe, they're not going to get off the Dan Ryan at Marquette to come to 63rd and Halsted.
Yes.
They're going to stay on the expressway and come down to Roosevelt.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the thing, you know, when you try to bring economic development into your community, you know, you tell them Inglewood, you know, a red light go up, and we don't want that. It's a community where there are good people there. They're concerned. We want the same thing that anybody else wants, you know, safe schools.
Yes.
You know, nice homes, jobs. We want the same thing everybody else. You know, I don't know why people think it's different.
Absolutely. I'm going to do an identifier. You're watching the Nixon Report. If you'd like to be on this show, you can dial 312-918-2974 and find out how you can be a guest on the Nixon Report. Now, Alderman folks, what number do people punch to vote for you on February 9th? I believe is early voting.
Correct.
I'd like you to talk about that. And February 24th is the election. How does this early voting work? And give us your punch number again.
Okay, my punch number is 53. So it's vote for me, punch 53, Alderman Tony Folks. And early voting in the 16th Ward will be at Lindblom Park. at the Fieldhouse.
You've got a long history with that park.
Yeah, I do. I do. So we're doing some great things over there. And we're having a new football field, which is very much needed. It's going to double or triple as a soccer field and a lacrosse field. And right down the street from Lindblom Park, which I'm very proud of, was Hermitage Park.
Yes.
And it was a little dinky, raggedy park. And we did a $600,000 new park, state-of-the-art park. Mm-hmm. It's the only design in the city of Chicago.
Wow.
And we had a community meeting, in which was amazing. Everyone that was at the meeting voted on the design that you see there.
That is amazing.
Everyone in the meeting.
So yeah. Now, on February 9th, people across the city can vote, but if you live in the 16th Ward, you can go to Lindblom
Fieldhouse.
And where is that located?
It's at 61st and Damon.
61st and Damon, and you can go in there and you can vote.
Punch 53.
You can punch 53. And the election is February
24th.
Mm-hmm. And people can go on that day and punch what?
53.
Now, but you are encouraging people to vote early.
Yes, definitely.
Why?
Well, it's just good to get it over with.
Okay.
You know, to get it over with. And then with the weather the way it is, you know,
yes.
We don't know what's going to happen. And we already, you know, we have a history of low turnout in our community. So people, please get out and vote. It's so important. You know, people lost their lives to give us this opportunity. So you
if
need to get out.
If people want to get engaged in your campaign, what number would they call?
They can call my campaign office, and that number is 773-737-1090.
Can you repeat that one more time?
773-737-1090.
Now back to the issue, just a little oversight. One of the things that I was engaged in, the Obama administration came out with a program called Broadband Technologies Opportunities Program, mm-hmm. and I was very much involved in working to bring about a contract for a company. They got $7 million and went into 14 cities, 23 different senior citizen buildings.
Mm-hmm.
And essentially what they did was they built computer learning centers. They trained the residents on how to operate computers.
Mm-hmm.
And they gave the residents in these buildings across northern Illinois free laptop computers. And one of the state-of-the-art sites of this program, a showcase and model for the entire community, is Churchview Senior Citizen Building, which is right in your ward.
Mm-hmm.
And you were very much involved in engaged in this whole process, and
mm-hmm.
tell me what your thoughts are on that in terms of this opportunity for senior citizens, because I know for a fact it increases their lives,
mm-hmm.
it gives them the opportunity to find out about the world, they can look for jobs, they can play games, they can
mm-hmm.
stay in contact with it. I mean, it's a mm-hmm. really good thing. Tell me about that.
It's great. I'm very, very active with my seniors. Spent a lot of time at Churchview. I just stopped by a lot of times. But during this program, I literally took part of it and interacted with the seniors there. And the amazing thing that I found out, and they were excited, but the amazing thing about the program, it was childlike and cartoon type. And they didn't have to, if they wanted to contact me, they didn't have to write my name out. All they had pictures, and all they had to do was press on the picture, and they would be linked to me. So it was, and then they got a computer at the end of the program. And also, it was even generated outside of the community.
Mm-hmm.
So we had some community residents. Actually, my mom came, a lady from our church, one of the sisters from our church. So it kind of had a, you know, that ripple effect. So it was really, they went outside of the community, outside of the community of Churchview, shall I say. And some regular community residents were also able to come and to see the facility, because it's a great facility. You know, you have independent living and you have supportive living.
Yes.
And the directors over there do wonderful things with our seniors. Sometimes they think they're in senior buildings and they just sit there. I take trips with them.
Yes.
You know, I take field
Absolutely.
Trips with them. I'm very, very active with my
yes,
seniors.
Yes, I know that you have a track record of that. So this is a concept that you probably be interested in applying. The 16th Ward is full of senior citizen buildings.
Mm-hmm.
And so I imagine that you would probably work to try to expand this kind of activity mm-hmm. in senior citizen buildings in the 16th Ward. The other part of this is you've been very, very engaged in education.
Very much engaged in education.
Tell us something about your long track record.
Oh, well, like I say, I've been in the community for a long time. I have two high schools, and that was in the current ward, and that's Harper and Lindblom. Lindblom is pretty set. Harper had a lot of challenges in 2007
Harper
when I came.
Harper was on national television.
TV.
Michelle Obama came.
Yeah.
I live about two blocks from there.
Right.
She came all the way from D.C.
Right.
to visit Harper High School.
And those babies over there, they are doing wonderful. They know who I am.
Yes, they do.
They last year, I think we got one Bill Gates scholar this year. A couple of years ago, we had two Bill Gates scholars. I am only on two boards. One of them is Embark, that is at Harper High School, and we've expanded to other schools as well. But it gets the kids out of the community.
Yes.
Let them know. You have children in certain areas that think when they come downtown that they're in a different state, believe it or not. You know, are we still in Chicago? And to get them out of their community, out of a square block radius, and know that there's a world outside. And the kids are doing phenomenal. Their attendance rates are up. They're going to college. You know, so anything that I can do for the children and the young adults, I'm there. I don't have children of my own. So that little extra time that I have, I spend it with kids. I'm very active with, I support it. I didn't want any school to close in my ward. I had no school closing. One consolidation.
Now that is an amazing. Can you say
yeah.
that you didn't have any schools closed?
No school.
You
closed.
Fought hard for that.
I went to Springfield.
Boy,
that's right
I bet
that.
You made a few. I guess you had made a few of these people that were so bent on closing schools mm-hmm. unhappy.
Yeah.
But that's a good thing for our community. Mm-hmm. Now. Jobs and economic development, that
mm-hmm.
is a big thing. I live in mm-hmm. West Englewood. I know that mm-hmm. that there's some really good stuff happening in our community that people don't see.
Mm-hmm.
I know that there are a lot of young people that would like to work.
Mm-hmm.
They'd like to have opportunities. There are
mm-hmm.
older people that would like to work. There are even senior citizens
mm-hmm.
that'd be interested yes. in working. So. You've had great success in pushing for jobs and economic development.
Mm-hmm.
Tell us about your efforts and your ideas mm-hmm. and your intentions relative to job training
mm-hmm.
and jobs and economic development in the 16th Ward.
Well, I think not only in the 16th Ward, again, Ward Beyond Boundaries.
Ward
just
beyond
because
boundaries.
It's, what about the people right across the street?
Yes,
you know,
absolutely.
So it's all about us.
Okay.
It's all about us.
Okay.
So I really believe that in order to build anything, you have to have a strong foundation.
Yes.
And that strong foundation is an investment in human capital.
Yes.
You know, our children have seen a lot. They've been through a lot. And they need the training that they, training to go on to jobs. When you have lived in a household where you have not seen your parents get up every day to go to work, you don't have that job, you know, that work ethic. I am also vice president of the board for Paul Simon's Job Corps. So I spend a lot of time with young adults over there, which are being trained for the trades, for pharmacy, for nursing. So. So those things are important. And the reason I joined that is because then my children in my community have a direct link there. And again, they have to, we have to invest in human capital, and not just our young people. Those young people grow up to adults. So yes, they're 25, 30 year olds that they don't have job training and job, you know, that work ethic that's so important.
I like that name, Paul Simon. You know, Paul Simon was a good friend of mine when I worked in the coordination of mm-hmm. the Harold Washington campaign in 1983. Paul Simon actually came and worked at Precinct with me.
Mm-hmm, okay.
Very dedicated man.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to do an identifier. You're watching the Nixon Report. If you want to find out more about this program, you can dial 312-918-2974. The Nixon Report is produced by Leon Loving. Want to give a great shout out to Leon Loving. He produces a number of television shows, including My Guests Ain't Guessing. All right, now let's talk a little bit mm-hmm. about your independence. One thing that I really like about you is that you are unbought and unbossed. And it seemed to me, just in my vision, the Chicago Street Journal newspaper, mm-hmm. which I am an associate publisher of, has endorsed you.
Mm-hmm.
And it's one of the reasons is because of your independence. You seem to vote only for those things that are in interest of your community. You know, there's some people mm-hmm. in the city council, they'll just vote for anything that they're told to do. They've been pulled into the back room and said, now you vote for this or else. But you, and I'm thinking that may be one of the reasons why the gerrymandered your ward have a track record and are known as being a independent, a progressive, and if I might say this, one, if not the most progressive alderman in the Chicago City Council. Can you speak to this? I mean, I know for a fact, I've seen in action, that there's nobody that pulls you in the back of the room and tells you what to do except your constituents.
That's it. I'm bossed, definitely, but I'm bossed by the people back at home.
All right, now.
And that's the reason I'm there. And I'm more afraid of the constituents than I am of anybody.
Yeah, all right now.
Okay.
And
you know, and you talk about, you know, the unions. They always kind of talk about the unions, but the unions are the constituents.
Yes.
You know, I was a union member. I was a constituent.
Yes.
And that's why they put me there.
Absolutely.
To fight for them, and I believe that's what I've done, and I'm proud of that. So.
Well, one of the things that people seem to be interested in is how can they help you to get elected? I've had people that even call me when I was talking to people about that I was going to be doing an interview with you. They wanted to know, what can they do to help you to get elected?
Well, they can come and volunteer and basically get on the phones, phone bank. Tell the people on the other end of the phone why they're phone banking. You know, I have people, constituents from the 15th Ward that phone bank, and they tell their stories. You know, you all don't know how lucky you are to get, you know, we're losing her,
yeah,
but,
yeah.
You know, so tell those stories. And when you talk from the heart, that's heart touches heart. So if they believe in me, they can come and help however they like. Sometimes it's just good to just come down and sit and keep someone else company. You know, people don't like to talk on the phones. Whatever you want to do, we don't turn anybody down.
Well, you know, we were talking about this scripture,
mm-hmm.
which I was very impressed by,
mm-hmm.
because I could feel this one, because, and it's in Galatians. It's Galatians 4:16. I am therefore, I have become your enemy, because I tell you the truth. Am I therefore become your enemy because I tell you the truth? I've been accused of being radical and, you know, there's certain things I won't do for money. People have looked at me and scorned me. I could tell you all kinds of stories, but I sleep good at night. I don't have anybody looking for me. I haven't taken no bribes in positions of public trust that I've held over the years in the government. And it's just a good feeling to be squeaky clean. And that's what I like about you, your integrity. But it seems in the last 3 or 4 minutes that we have in this program that there is a super PAC going after you because you speak truth to power.
Yeah.
You're not like one of them boss people that they go in the back room and say, yes, sir, boss, I'm going along with this. I'll vote out whatever you say. You're not that type of person.
No, I'm not.
Tell me about what's going on.
Well, you know, they have to do what they have to do. And the first time I ran, I had a big bucks come against me. So now I got a super PAC, so I must be doing something super.
So they're trying to get you.
I guess so. So they can keep trying.
Yeah, but it's not going to work because the people support you.
You know what? I tell people, when I go to City Hall, I am the voice of the people. The day that I go to City Hall and I'm not the voice of the people, nobody has to spend $1, not one super PAC dollar or any other dollar, to get rid of me. I'll quit.
Wow, that's powerful. You're part of what they call the Chicago 7.
I don't know.
7 independent, progressive aldermen that they fight different things that are trying to be put on the people that may not be in the people's best interest. Well, we got 1 minute left. I really want to thank you for the opportunity to interview you. And tell me again, what number do they punch to elect you in the 16th Ward for Alderman?
Punch 53. Alderman Tony Folks, candidate for the 16th Ward. Vote for me, punch 53.
And give me your phone number again to the campaign office.
The campaign office is 773-737-1090.
And I want to tell you guys that it's just been a real opportunity to have Alderman Tony Folks as a guest on the Nixon Report. I want to thank Leon Loving, my producer, and all the people that are engaged in making this production possible. I want to reach way back and thank my good friend, the late Morgan Carter, who was my mentor, and he taught me a lot of things about the media business, media relations, television. Probably one of the greatest public relations, media relations councils in the world. Good night, Morgan.